everybody, this is Indium here, welcoming you back to another episode of Let's Play The Legend of Zelda Wind Waker. Right, last time we got into the Forsaken Fortress, and we picked up this Skull Hammer by defeating Phantom Ganon. There's a little bit of trivia behind the Skull Hammer. Did you know that, like in the original development of Wind Waker, that they weren't actually going to keep the Skull Hammer design? Instead, they were just going to use like a regular tool hammer or something. They were just going to use like a regular hammer design instead of using the cool badass fucking skull design that they kept within the final product. Get out of here, you stupid asses. I'm trying to explain something. These things are annoying as hell. They constantly respawn, so just don't even bother trying to kill them. They're more of a hassle than anything. I think that's the whole purpose of their existence, is just to cause hassle. Get out. But the Megaton Hammer, well, I was about to say Megaton Hammer, just then, oh, damn it. But the Skull Hammer makes pretty quick work of them anyways, so if you want to just wipe them all out in one swing, just use the Skull Hammer. I think we have to use the Deck Leaf, actually, to get across this. Okay, not like that, though. I think we have to do it at the height of our jump. So, let's just do that again. This time not fail. Oh, come on, man. I was climbing up the ladder and you have to just go ahead and do that? Seriously? I mean, these were the big problem in the friggin' submarine. When I was doing the submarine, they were really putting me off from killing the wizards. And I couldn't even hit the wizards because these guys are just all over the place. Dude! Peace? Oh, God for that. Man, I wasn't gonna climb that thing three times in a row. And I missed the jump. Alright, there's a whole swarm of these things, just... You know, I'm just gonna go the other way if I can't get up here. Because there's two ways you can go. All you have to do is just get through the Forsaken Fortress pretty much the same way you went the first time. Get to the jail cell, and that's all you have to do. You don't have to do any more exploration of this place. I mean, the only real treasure that you could get if you left it behind is peace of heart, which I did. This is so dumb. I've been trying to climb this for like the past minute now, and I'm not getting anywhere with it. Well, you know what? I'm just gonna lure these guys around, and then I'm gonna quickly get on the ladder and then climb. So, kiss my ass. Now you can't get up here. Alright, can we just, like... Well, why don't we just do this? Is this right here? Yeah, that's easier. Alright. I would have saved a whole bunch of time if I realized that I could do that. Oh, well, it's never too late. Because we still have plenty of time left on the recording, still. Man, that room was a mess. Okay, I think this is actually... I'm hoping this is the main room, but I'm not entirely certain on that. Okay, no, it's not. Alright, now we're gonna have to use the Deku Leaf because there's no dangling lantern that we can swing across on, so... Yep. So you want to stick to the top floor, don't stick to the bottom floor, because if you go down on the bottom floor, then you're gonna be in the bottom of the main room, and that's not gonna take you upstairs, so... Make sure you're on the top floor. I'm not sure if this is the main room. It might be. Yeah, it is. Okay, this is where we want to be, so... And I'm 100% certain that there is nothing else that we can do here. I don't think there are any other heart pieces we can get. If there is, then I can just look it up. Actually, don't need rupees for a change. I got 694, so it's not like I'm broke. And I don't think there's any point in the game where you would actually need to really max out your wallet to 5,000 rupees, because I don't think there's an item in this game that even costs 5,000 rupees. do the merchant trading sequence, which also takes up a lot of money. I actually did some research on that online, and I've got a list of how the trading sequence works. So there's apparently multiple different ways you can do the trading sequence, but I'm probably just going to go with the easier way of doing it, so I'm just going to refer to the list that I have and just work from there when we decide to do that. I might even do it after doing the Forsaken Fortress, because all we have to do is deliver that town flower to a Goron merchant on one of the islands. But there's one island that we haven't been to yet that has a merchant on, so I'm thinking of going to that island first, and it's a main quest island as well, so I might do the, get further into the main quest until we get to that specific island, and then start doing the trading sequence. The island's called Mother and Child Island, I think that's what the name is. Yeah, as you can see, you can just skimmy right across into these freaking spotlights here, and they don't do anything. Or maybe they do. I'm being shot at by cannons. I don't know if that's a good thing. Oh yeah, that's not good at all. Okay, where is that coming from? Well, there's no worries about that. I can just make a cut and meet you guys back up there, but looks like we have to take care of these things first. Shoot. Well, I didn't know that happened. I thought we were in the all clear, but obviously not. Let's get our bombs out and do away with these cannons, so then we can get somewhere with us. We just need to get a good aim, so we can actually see where these things are. Okay, there's one over there. That's not gonna hit, that's too high. Okay. I think they're all just in this general area right here, so you can break this door down too, I think, with bombs, but there's no point really, because I don't see the point. Can you break this wall down? I don't think you can, because it's got steel plating on it, it's not all wooden. So, right, this should be all the cannons, right? Okay, they're all taken care of, so they won't get in the way of things. Alright, I'm gonna make a cut and I'll see you guys back at where I got blown off from the wall. So I will, I'll see you then. Alright guys, I'm back. We still have a problem with bomb cannons and stuff, but I think I've got an idea that might actually work. I don't know if this will, but I'm gonna give it a shot. I think you guys already know what that is gonna be, so we're just gonna basically skip out doing the whole shimmying across the wall crap, and we'll just pretty much fly over there using the deck, you believe. I don't know if that's actually gonna work. It might do. Well, if I would, it would help if I stopped getting blown up here. And wow, it actually did. Holy shit. Why didn't I do that the first time, man? I don't know, that's crazy. Okay, I know you're not supposed to do it like that, at least I don't think you are. Right, let's get the skull hammer out, because these are just going to endlessly respawn, so okay, if we can actually hit the switch, that would help. I thought that was, like, automatically targeting this thing.